Hi, my name is Geeta Khan. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to make 5 recipes with only 1 dosa batter. So what are we waiting for? Let's get started with the video. But before we can make the recipes, we need the dosa batter. So now I'm going to show you how to prepare the dosa batter. For the dosa batter, we need to add a small glass of boiled rice into the bowl. Then the same amount of urad dal, which is 1 small glass. Now we need to add 3 small glasses of raw rice. Tablespoon of chana dal. And finally, 1 tablespoon of methi seeds. Then I'm washing it neatly. Now soak these ingredients in water for 6 hours and I'll see you after the 6 hours are done. After I have cleaned it, I've transferred it into a blender and I'm going to add some water into it. This is how it looks after I've blended it. Now we're gonna keep this batter overnight and see it in the morning. It's the next day and I'm going to transfer half of the batter into another bowl. Now take the bowl that you have transferred the batter into and add some salt into it. And add some baking soda into it. And mix. After mixing, we're going to make the dosa. Dosa is a healthy breakfast option for people who need to keep a check on their fat intake. A high amount of saturated fat increases the risk of heart diseases and a number of other health problems. Dosas are low on saturated fat, which makes them a healthy and safe breakfast option. Now take the leftover batter and add some cumin seeds into it. Then add some curry leaves and coriander. These 5 recipes are some of my favorite recipes to make. Then add some chilies into the batter. Then I'm going to add the onions into it and mix it all together. After mixing it, I'm going to add some water into it. Now I'm going to make some uttapam. With the same batter, I'm also going to make the paniyaram. Paniyaram, paddu, guliyappa, eriyappa, guntapanganalu or appadaddi is an Indian dish made by steaming batter using a mold. This batter is made of black lentils and rice and is similar in composition to the batter used to make idli and dosa. The dish can also be made sweet or spicy depending on the ingredients, jaggery and chilies respectively. Paniyaram is made on a special pan that comes with multiple small fissures as this one. It is known by various names in South India, including the ones that I have mentioned. Thank you. The spicy paniyaram is ready. Now I'm going to take some more of the batter and add some chopped coconut into it. Then I'm going to add some cardamom powder into it. Now I'm going to add 5 teaspoons of jaggery powder. You can add it according to how much sweet you want your paniyaram to be. Now mix it all together. Then we can make our sweet paniyaram. Now let's begin with making the paniyaram. All these recipes that we're making today are going to be so delicious. I hope you'll try these recipes. Did you know that paniyaram is mostly eaten in the states of Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana from the South India? Just look at how delicious these paniyarams are turning out. I can't wait to taste these. The sweet paniyaram is ready. Now we're going to use all the batter that we have left. So keep the batter ready. Then add some cardamom powder into it. Then add some blended coconut into it. Then mix well. After mixing, add some jaggery powder according to your taste. I'm adding 5 teaspoons. Mix in some water and make the sweet dosa. You might have tasted several different varieties of spicy dosas, but have you ever tasted a sweet jaggery dosa? If not, why not make this dosa and enjoy it with your family and friends anytime? Sweet and delicious. The jaggery dosa is a South Indian delicacy and can be prepared easily. This dosa can be prepared for lunch and dinner, but is more suitable for breakfast in winter and monsoon season. So why wait? Just try this easy recipe today at home and enjoy with your loved ones. It's really healthy. It has anti-allergic properties and controls diseases like asthma, bronchitis, allergy and other respiratory ailments. It also cleanses the body, prevents anemia, relieves joint pain, controls blood pressure, prevents constipation, detoxifies the liver, cures menstrual pain, boosts immunity and purifies the blood. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you liked it. If you did, don't forget to press the like button and subscribe to my channel and watch all of my other videos and share this with your friends and family. And look how tasty these recipes have turned out. Please make these recipes and let me know in the comments how they have turned out. Bye! I'll be seeing you in my next video.